Okay.
So, coming to sit on a chair or something. Finding the soles of the feet resting flat on the earth. So coming to the edge of the chair if you can't reach the floor comfortably, or if you have two blocks, you can sit back and place the blocks under your feet. Yeah. Shoulders roll up, back, and slide down. And we find the breath. Aware of the support beneath you and how the body is meeting that support. Feet resting on the earth, letting go of all efforting in the legs. The back of the thighs and the hips resting in the seat of the chair. Releasing any tension or efforting you might feel in the lower back and the hips, using the exhales. Aware of the breath filling the space below the collarbone. And maybe you'd like to set an intention for your practice, for your day, something you're working on. Shortening that to a word or a phrase and placing it in an I am statement. Repeating it softly to yourself a few times as if it were true and already happening. Gently allowing the focus to come back to the breath, maybe inviting the breath a little deeper, becoming aware of the side body, the side ribs, allowing them to accept the breath as the lungs fill. Moving to the last ribs, that space in line with the belly button on the side body. And breathing into that space wherever there are ribs, there is lung tissue, allowing the breath to restore you, inviting the breath in, softly releasing the breath out. Two more rounds of breath like this. Your eyes are closed, softly blinking them open, allowing the fingertips to reach towards the earth. Finding integrity in the pose by inhaling and lifting straight up through the crown of the head, becoming aware of the core body active to keep the spine long. With your inhale, scooping up the energy surrounding you, and exhaling, bringing it through this crown of the head, resting in the heart center. Three more rounds like this. Moving the arms in their sockets. No effort, just breath, guiding movement. And allowing the hands to rest at the heart center. If you've placed blocks under your feet, removing them. And scooting forward to the edge of your chair so that you're aware of the sitting bones, maybe rooting down, resting on the chair and the lengthening of the spine straight up, extending the fingertips towards the earth. With your inhale, the arms float up overhead. With your exhale, the heart twists a little to the right and the arms float down. Wherever they land, no effort. Inhale, floating back up to neutral center. Exhaling, gentle twist to the left. Important to inhale, find that space from or between the sternum and the belly button. Keep that space. Find the breath with your next inhale, lengthen with your exhale, gentle twist, floating the arms down. Nice. Inhale back to center. Exhale, gentle twist. Nice. Last time, inhaling back to center, exhaling, hands float through the heart center. Palms rest on the upper thighs. Slide the feet back an inch or two. You'll want that for stability. We're inhaling, lengthening through the crown of the head. Exhale, hinging forward from the hip creases, keeping that length through the front body, softening the back of the neck. Inhale all the way up. Exhale, hinge forward. Feeling weight into the feet, the legs becoming active. What are you becoming aware of? As you exhale, light in the hips. Inhale up. This time we're going to stand all the way up, exhaling, pressing into the feet, inhaling with a long spine. Nice. Coming all the way to stand, bringing the chair to the top of the mat with the seat facing you. Nice. So moving, flowing with the breath to get that energy moving to warm up the body. Finding your expression of mountain pose, where does it feel comfortable for you to root the feet to the earth, to allow the arms to extend, to lengthen through the crown of the head. And with your inhale, those arms float out and around and maybe up. And with your exhale, we swan dive forward. Maybe the palms press to the ceiling. What do you like to do? Inhaling, floating up to stand. Exhaling, bringing it to the heart center. Nice. Using the breath to guide you to inhale and find that length and strength. To exhale and float forward, anchored by those feet. To inhale, lengthen through the crown of the head, soften through the back of the neck. Exhale, gather the belly. Inhale, floating up. Exhaling, heart center. This time we'll maybe step it back if that feels right for you. Inhaling, finding the length. Exhaling, hinging forward. Now the hands plant on that chair. Soften the arms in their sockets. Slide the shoulder blades down the back. And then again, find that core, the belly gathering without compromising the breath. Weight in the fingertips, no efforting in the ankles. You're breathing. We're rocking the weight over the right leg so that we can step that left foot back, curling the toes under any amount. Inhale there, exhale, step that foot forward to meet the right. Inhale there, exhale, weight shifts to the left leg. Inhale, stepping that right foot back. Nice. Exhale, the belly gathers and the foot steps forward. And as we inhale, we come all the way up to stand. Hands float to heart center. Knees are bent throughout until you come all the way up to stand. That's to soften the hamstrings, no tugging on the lower back. So aware of the knees. Using your breath, remember I'm making suggestions. You can be faster or slower. Finding your Tadasana. Inhaling there. Exhaling, rooting into the circumference of your heels. Inhaling, floating the arms out, around, and up. Exhale, maybe swan dive down. Inhaling, rooting to the chair, finding length through the back body. Exhale. Weight over the right leg. To inhale, step that left leg back. Any amount. Knee is over ankle. Gaze is to the space between the thumbs. Find the breath. Exhale, gather the pit of the belly. Step that left foot forward. Inhale there. Exhale, weight comes into the left leg. to inhale that right leg back. Nice, soft shoulders, the core is working. Exhaling, that right foot steps or slides forward. Inhale, root all the way down, come all the way up. Exhale, heart center. Pause here, take a couple of rounds of breaths, check in. What sensations are running through your body right now? What do you notice? What do you feel? Has the breath become ragged or uneven? Can you smooth it out? Maybe even making the exhales a little longer than the inhales. Is the weight more on the balls of the feet or the heels? Can you notice? Is it obvious? Can you root into the circumference of the heels? Let the toes rest softly. Can you tell if your hips are forward? If you need to draw the tops of the thighs back, notice how you feel in the seam of where the legs come into the hips. That looks great. Awesome. Breathe there. With your next inhale, the arms float out, around, and up. With your exhale, hinge forward. Maybe the palms press back and up. Inhale, plant the hands the whole while the core is engaged. The knees are soft and the hip creases reach back. Nice. Rocking the weight over the right leg to extend into that left. Straight out from the hips. The upper body stays right where it is with your next and your breathing. And with your exhale, you're rooting into that right foot to step that or left or slide the left foot forward. Soften there, bend into the knees, reach the hip creases back, allow the front and back body nice to be long. Weight shifts over the left foot, so that you can step that right foot straight back. Upper body stays right there. Breathing, gazing to the thumbs. Exhale, there that right foot slides or steps forward, equal weight on both feet. Inhale, soften through the shoulders. Exhale, root into the feet and inhale, float all the way up to stand. Exhaling, heart center. Pause for two rounds of breath. Even it out. Nice. So, walking, I want to say the middle of your mat. Yeah. Up to about the middle of your mat if your chair is at the front. The chair is secure, right? The feet, the legs of the chair are at least the front legs. Are on the top of the mat so it doesn't shift, or on a carpet that you know it won't move. Nice. So continuing with these sun salutes, normally you would step back from those lunges into downward facing dog. Well, this is our expression of downward facing dog today. So we're rooting into the heels to activate the legs, to lengthen through the crown of the head. And with our inhale, the arms float out, around, and up. With our exhale, we bend the knees, reach the hip creases back, plant the hands on the chair. Maybe this is where you'll stay, reaching the hip creases back, allowing the head to float between your arms. Maybe you'll walk the feet back. Experiment your body, your practice. What do you notice? So start with the palms of your hands resting on the chair, resting on the chair. The arms are active, the elbows extended without being locked. The arms settle in the shoulder sockets. We're breathing here, no effort in the jaw, the back of the neck. The belly is slightly gathered to support the lower back. The knees are bent and the hip creases reach back to where the wall meets the ceiling. So it's up and back. And we move into the hips and the lower back. How do they feel? What do you notice? Do you need to soften somewhere? How about the backs of the thighs? Maybe this is where you'll stay. Maybe you'll straighten into that right knee a little, feel a deeper warm sensation in the belly of the back of the thigh, not the joints. Maybe you'll bend into the right knee and straighten a little into the left. Where do you feel this? Calf, back of the thigh, bottom of the foot, lower back. Be kind to yourself. Be curious. Don't let the head hang. So the ears, yes, beautiful. You don't need to see, just feel. Sometimes I close my eyes when I practice to cut off that sense so I can feel a little deeper and connect with the body. And then we'll find stillness here. Exhale, gather the belly. One hand comes to the hip crease. And then the other. Long spine, root into the feet. Inhale all the way up to stand. Pause here. Connect with the breath. Even it out. Is there any sensation of dizziness or heart racing or the breath? Is it smooth and even? Just noticing. I'm just suggesting some things that I observe in a morning practice. You might have something totally different going on. And we don't judge it. We just become aware so we can be kind to ourselves and not, and back out of things that don't feel right, right? Okay. Let's float a little in and out of this downward dog. So we're extending through the fingertips, rooting into the circumference of the heels, inhaling, floating the arms out, around and up. Exhale, hinging forward from the hip creases, and then reaching towards the chair and floating into your expression of downward facing dog. Ears alongside the arms, or arms in alignment with the ears, long spine. So the tailbone's neither tipped up nor down, but back and up. Nice. Belly is gently gathered. Breathing into the heart space. And then working your dog in a way that suits you. So bending and straightening both knees one at a time. Maybe walking the feet back a little further. You'll get deeper into the calves. What does your downward dog look like? Maybe turning this into a balancing pose as you allow the weight to shift into the right leg, and the knee can still be soft and engaged. And inhaling, extending that left leg up to the ceiling and out of the hips. Maybe not today. Maybe that foot just rests on the floor behind you. Both hips face the earth. Soften the shoulders. Exhale. Let that foot float to the earth. Regroup. Settle in. Knees are soft. Weight shifts over the left leg so that you can inhale and reach through the right, or rest it on the floor in front of you. How are your shoulders? Exhale there. Float that foot down. Deeply bend the knees. Float one hand and then the other to the hip creases. Draw the shoulder blades to the center of the back and lengthen the heart as you inhale, but soften the back of the neck. Exhale, root into the soles of the feet. Beautiful. Inhale all the way up to stand. Exhale, float it to the heart center. And pause here in the stillness of your mountain pose. Aware of the breath. And any other sensation. Nice. And we'll use that chair to come back down to the floor. So stepping a little closer to the top of your mat. So that we can inhale and float those arms up one more time. And exhale, bow forward with a long front and back body. to plant the hands so that we can step one knee back and then the other. And then the hands walk down to the floor and we pause here, walking back to the center to find our cat and cow. So set yourself up first. Don't rush to get into the poses, right? The journey matters. Rooting into the palms of the hands with active legs and peaceful shoulders, exhaling, rounding the spine to the ceiling, maybe even dropping the crown of the head. Inhaling, tailbone lifts, belly softens, heart extends between the arms, maybe lifting the gaze slightly. Nice, exhaling. It's curious about the movement in the back body. Inhaling, allowing that heart to reach between the gates of the arms. Moving in and out with your breath, three more rounds like this, pausing in the stillness if that suits you. Maybe it's important for you to come into that back bend a little longer than the forward fold. What do you notice? Are you efforting to do one or the other? Or are you meeting the body wherever it is today? Nice, last round. After that inhale, we find a neutral spine, walking the big toes to touch and the knees wide. A couple of rounds of breath in child pose that suits you, pausing for the journey, allowing a full long spine to rest on the earth, forehead making contact with something. Inhaling, finding the space in back of the heart. Exhaling, softening through the shoulders and the jaw and the hips. Nice. And then inhaling to come up to sit, allowing the hips to come to one side and the legs to extend straight out in front of you, walking up to the top of the mat. Sorry. One hand and then the other comes in back of the thighs. You soften the shoulders away from the ears and lengthen the crown of the head straight up to the ceiling. And the entire core body, front, back, and side becomes active without efforting. The breath is smooth from the pit of the belly through the crown of the head. The energy keeps you long. Nice. Maybe this is where you'll stay. Maybe you're floating to the top of the sacrum, opening up that angle in the hip crease. But it's not the hands and the arms that are holding you up, but that core body, the muscles that hug to keep a long spine so that you're not collapsing the lower back to the earth. So the heart is still lifting up to where the wall meets the ceiling. Otherwise, you're coming back up to where we started. Breathing here, maybe one hand and then the other opens to the ceiling. Maybe not today. Shoulders are soft. Throat is open, aware of the heart, lifting, reaching forward between the armpits, yes? Maybe you can lift one foot. Maybe that one floats down and the opposite foot lifts. Maybe both feet float for a breath and then rest on the earth. Experimenting and backing out of anything that doesn't suit you. Chairs in front of you, maybe the feet rest on the chair and you can challenge the core with the legs resting. And then maybe you bring your hands to the floor, float down to elbows and allow the entire spine to come to rest. Big inhale, softening exhale. Sighing the breath out, landing safe on the earth, releasing into that support. With your next exhale, the belly gathers in one knee and then the other draws in for a hug. Maybe you rock from side to side. Not rushing it. Grateful for this time to check in with your body, what you're clinging to use the breath to soften and release whatever that is. Allowing the feet to float to the earth, walking them the width of the mat, and finding your reclined windshield wiper, floating the knees to one side, up to center, and over to the other, guided by the breath. What do you find? What do you notice? Not judging it, but just noticing. Accepting wherever you are today. Nice. And then coming to stillness there. Inhaling, that right leg extends up to the ceiling as you reach into the heel and roll through that ankle. Soft back of the knee. Bend the toes away from each other, curl them in. Flex and point. Nice. Exhale, draw that knee in for a gentle hug. Nice. And then make some small circles in the hip and reverse them. Forward, back, side to side. Doesn't have to be circles. Moving in the hip. And then rotating that knee out to the side so that you can cross the ankle over the thigh. Sacrum, center of the hips, resting on the earth. Breathing into the heart space. Maybe you have space for that left heel to walk a little closer as you invite that right knee to move away from you. Maybe with your exhale, both knees float over to the left as if you could stand that right foot up on the floor with the knee to the ceiling. Inhale up to center. Arms can be out in T, in cactus or goddess arms, or soft out to the side. What do you notice in the side body? As the shoulders rest on the earth, how are you being in this flow of twist? Are you forcing it? Are you honoring your body? Are you being kind to yourself? Last time, and then floating up to center. Inhale, extend that leg one more time. Get movement if it feels good. And with your exhale, bend the knee. Float that foot to the floor. Inhaling that left leg straight up. Straight is a relative term. Soft in the back of the knee. Rotate through the ankle one direction. And then the other, bend the toes out, curl them in. And with your exhale, hug that knee in. And then get some movement in the hip socket if that feels right. Remember, I only offer suggestions. And then finding stillness there. Floating the left knee out to the side so that you can cross that ankle over the thigh. Pausing here. Maybe this side feels a little different. Maybe this is where you'll stay. Maybe stepping that right heel a little closer if you have the space as you offer that left knee to move away. Keeping that left foot flexed. Maybe with the exhale, you're floating both knees over to the right. Inhale up to center, exhale. So you're moving so slowly that you know where the center of the back is. You come to rest on the sacrum, not shifting the weight to the left. Just bringing some mindfulness in. It's not like it's good or bad. Just moving with intention. Maybe one more round like this. Left knee points away. Right knee hinges over, inhaling up to center. Maybe that leg extends one more time and you get a little more movement, and then you bend the knee and float that foot to the earth. Exhaling, drawing the knees in for a final hug. And then floating them straight out onto the floor in front of you for a mini Shavasana. Maybe the legs walk a little wide, maybe the knees stay bent. Surrendering to the earth beneath you, allowing it to support your entire body, allowing the body to become heavy and the breath to become smooth and even, your natural rhythm, peaceful, filling the space below the collarbone. Using those exhales to soften the eyes, the jaw, all the muscles in the face melt to the earth. And so we practice yoga asana to go from acting or moving from habit to mindfully making wise choices. We bring loving awareness to the felt experience. We allow the breath and the wise heart to guide us. And we bring our practice off our mats and into our everyday life. Aware of your body resting on the earth, becoming aware of the space surrounding you. So gently deepen your inhales and exhales, and slowly, gently bringing your body back from stillness with small movements. And when you're ready, maybe inhaling and extending the arms up overhead. And then exhaling, floating them to a comfortable position as you bend one knee and then the other to step the feet softly onto the earth. Transitioning here, using the breath, the prana, to restore you, feeling more awake and alert with every inhale. Relaxed and peaceful. Bringing to mind the intention you started your practice with. Maybe you'll carry that with you throughout the day. Using your arm as a pillow, rolling over to one side or the other. As you allow the breath to fill the front and back of the heart space. And when you're ready, using the palms to press into the earth and draw yourself up, keeping the eyes closed if that suits you, into a comfortable, easy, peaceful seated position. And maybe you inhale the arms one more time to extend, opening through the heart space and exhaling, the palms float together to rest there. The center of the heart, and we lift our hearts and we bow our heads to honor that perfect light that shines in all of us and unites us, with the intention that our practice be continuous, that we bring yoga into our breath and step. Let our hearts be steady for ourselves and for each other. And we dedicate our efforts to be of benefit to all beings. May all beings be safe. May they be healthy. May they be happy. May all beings find their freedom. May they know peace. And may they move through the world with ease. Namaste. Thank you all for sharing this practice with me.